Hello. I'm in the beautiful park that I wanted to shoot the other video in, but there were too many people. I feel like I can be inconspicuous this time. I'm wearing the shirt that I made. This shirt took me about 8 months to make because, see all of the different patches? I sewed them together using a method called English paper piecing, which was developed in England, but also maybe there was an Italian process similar, but basically you use paper to stabilize the different pieces of fabric that you want to sew together, but just like, you know, a piece of paper and then like another thing that fits around it perfectly. And this way you can do irregular shapes that would be difficult to do on the sewing machine. It's really cool if you ever see quilts that were made using this method that still have the bits of paper or card in the back, because you can see the ephemera from the time. Hexagons are a really common kind of... they're a really common shape for this quilt, this kind of piecing. I've started about 5 English paper piecing quilts. Have I finished any of them? No. It takes a very long time because you have to stitch them by hand. You might have noticed me and my friends stitching pieces for this shirt together in another video. And I did enlist my friends to help me so that I could finish this faster because it takes such a long time. Also, I did a weird thing to this shirt. It has a hole in the pocket. I mean, the pocket is a void pocket. And that was the original plan for the shirt. But the bias tape was so fiddly going around the corners, and I don't know why I couldn't do it, because I have sewn so much bias tape in my life. I spent weeks only stitching, hand stitching bias tape for an artist that I worked for a couple of years ago. I do like the void pocket. And all of the pieces in this shirt are made from other shirts that I found. It's a shirt of shirts. This mountain I made from recycled apple crates. And I like to call them lonely socks, but they're the socks that have lost their mate, and I hate throwing them away, so I just saved them forever in a bag. I shredded them up and I put them in the pulp that I made, along with scraps from my serger. And those beautiful purple apple crates, which I love. My wonderful advisor, Linda, knew a place in Saint-Hilaire that had lots of clay. It was an apple orchard, and it was just incredible because I guess I never knew where clay came from really before that. It was the first time I'd really seen a lot of clay in the nature, and we spent all day digging clay out of this stream bed, and we shoveled gallons and gallons and gallons of it. Recently, I was playing around with it and made these. I always think that that area, Mont Saint-Hilaire, is really interesting and beautiful because the mountains just kind of seem to pop up out of the landscape and out of nowhere, like it's really flat, and then there'll just be this kind of hill that pops up. Geologists think that there was some kind of hot spot millennia ago, and then as the plate moves over the hot spot, it causes these intrusions, I think they're called. Intrusive rock is formed when magma penetrates existing rock, crystallizes and solidifies underground to form intrusions, for example, plutons, batholiths, dikes, sills, laccoliths, and volcanic necks. I was wondering if this had, like, I was reading about how clay is formed, or I guess the kinds of conditions that are necessary for clay to form. I guess geothermal fields and volcanic deposits are one of the kinds of places that have the conditions that clay forms. It might have something to do why clay is formed there. I was reading some different Abenaki creation myths because that area is Abenaki territory. I was just curious because I've been browsing through and learning about different creation myths from different places, and I was reading some Abenaki ones, and in one of the ones that I read, the creator spirit creates beings from clay. In the Abenaki language, Mont Saint-Hilaire is called Wigwame Danezibo, Wigwame Danezibo, which means, I think, a small house-shaped mountain.
You were a young boy, did you have a father?